Greetings friends, welcome back to my channel. It's so long since I've done a video that my beard's fallen off. What we got here? We have recently acquired this. So it's a Thorens, I think, record deck. It's not very well. And our mission is to try and return it to health. One thing I did notice is it comes with a lid, which is quite cool. I haven't seen many of them with a lid. But it does have some damage on it that we won't be able to polish out. Someone's like, is that hot flex or something on it? A bit strange. So, yeah, a bit damaged, but never mind. Came with information sheet for the cartridge. It's got a nice Shure cartridge fitted in. It's original Thorens, is that how you pronounce that? Original Thorens head shell, which is fitted to the deck. So enough waffle. Let's get a look at the deck. Okay, so here we are, we're all set up. So got the Thorens deck hooked up to an incongruously modern Technics mixer, and then that is hooked up to my wonderful Technics stereo there, so we are ready to go. So let's try some material. So the arms up. These are famed for their real squishy suspension, so yeah, good shock absorption on these things. So, it goes up to 33. Seems to spin up quite slowly. Okay. Right, drop one needle to the record. This is not copyright, by the way. This is an old London Symphony Orchestra recording. Okay, so, works on 33. We've got output. We'll check this out. Watch your ears. It's gonna suck. So looking at the mixer, hopefully you can see the gauge. So we can get reliable output on the left channel, but on the right channel, so this is the right RCA from the deck, we got all that noise, but if we get lucky, we can get output. So there's something wrong with this cable, we can hopefully fix that. Okay, so that's one problem. But mainly the thing's working, so that's good news. So, here's the other problem, so let's get that off. So remember, any copyright hounds that are watching, that's the LSO performing Mussorgsky's Night on Bear Mountain. It's nothing to do with Sony, it's always Sony with copyright hounding. Okay, so the next problem is going to involve playing copyright material, because I don't have any 45s that aren't copyright material. But I'll just play a very short blast. So this is a minor problem that the deck's got, just cosmetic. So where it says 3 in this corner should be 33, where it looks like it says plus 5 in this corner. It should be 45, but the letters are kind of worn. So we'll do something with that. We'll probably just remove the 33 and 45 entirely and just leave the 0 there. Or something, just so it makes a bit of sense cosmetically. Right, so 45. So again, kind of a slow start. This is great. Okay, so let's get that, drop the needle on there. Takes a long time for some reason. I think I've got a bit too much counterweight on it, but we'll sort that out. Noisy record, sorry. Okay. So that's that should have been Lionel Richie, but it sounds like Barry White on sedatives. So yeah, there's a problem with playing at 45. So this is weird. So if you can play all right at 33, sorry, if you can play all right at 33, why can't you play all right at 45? Now, I've actually already investigated this. So this thing's quite cool. So 45 adapter is there you go. The machine center. What's going on with that? Oh, okay, coming through the stylus. Let's turn that mixer off. Okay, so underneath all this stuff is the most amazing speed change mechanism that I've ever seen. Not that I've seen that many, because I ain't no record player expert. Okay, I didn't expect that. The bloody like hub thing has come off. Okay, let's get you in a different position. Very close. So you can see this. See the goings on, what are going on. Okay, so. Well, okay. Yeah, so you get an idea how fucked that belt must be. So, in order to play a 33, our belt is running on this part of the motor spindle. Now check this out, to play a 45, an arm pops up and intends to cause the belt to run like up here. Now it slips down again. Yeah. So, like, that arm mechanically changes the speed. So 33, 45. Again, the belt is too slack for it to be able to run 45. But anyway, I'd already checked this out before embarking on making this video, and we ordered ourselves a new belt, supposedly to the correct specifications. I've got a box of generic belts, but none of those would suit. This is listed as being the correct belt for this particular turntable. Let's check it out. Set the arm on the 33. Okay. Here we go. Okay, we're on.
All right, cool.
So let's see what our crazy mechanical gear change thing does now. Okay. Well, it sounded a bit labored for a minute, didn't it? Doesn't sound too great when you notice you change from one speed to the other, but at least it does make it now. Okay, let's see if it's fixed our speed problem before we go too crazy. Man, that struggled. I don't know. Such a noisy record. Okay, so Lionel sounds like Lionel now. But our record player is so noisy now. So try 33 again, just to make sure that still works okay. Which it does. So we'll revisit this stuff. Cool. So we'll try and fix this. And we'll leave this running on 45. Hopefully we can get that belt sorted out. Whoa. I've got this little gadget that should help. So this is a... I can't remember how to use it. There we go. A fiberglass scratch pen. So hopefully you can see the pins are just getting polished up by this thing. I don't think it's the pins that are the problem though. I think it's the outers, and I don't think I'm really going to be able to get in there with this. What we'll do with the outers is crush things in together. So I'll push on the corners. Hopefully make the metal portions of these push in a bit. Ready? Yay! Output on both channels. No terrible noises. It's definitely not the best performance of Night on Bear Mountain that I've heard, so not to be a music snob or anything, but that's definitely the case. So let's have a quick go on a 45 again, just to be sure. Let me fix that. There we go. Thanks for the time. Cool. Thank you, Lionel. Okay, so in addition to audible tests, I think this is the first Beppel player I've had that doesn't have strobe markings around the outside. So I went on the old interwebs, got onto Scamazon, picked up a strobe disc. Now, I expected that bit, but seeing that bit set me up for expecting problems. And look at that. Bloody China. Can't do anything right. So I'm going to have to ream the centre out to make it a little larger so it'll sit on the deck. Oh dear, be back. Okay, so I fixed it. I just reamed it out a little bit with this. Okay, go for it. So I think what we're supposed to see is one track looks like it's staying still, which is this one. Is that the right one? Hertz. No, 50 hertz. In a ring, 45. Yeah, that's right. So we're on 50 hertz mains frequency in the UK. Unlike the USA, where you say things like 60 cycle hum, we don't get 60 cycle hum over here. We would get 50 cycle hum. So that would mean for 33, we should be looking at this track here. So this one. Yeah, pretty much. They're dancing that way ever so slightly. Huh. Far out. I don't know if that's going to come out on the camera. I think you're right there. I'll be interested to myself to see what happens. So, that's the track for 33. Let's see how that looks for you. And this is a track for 45, this one. So let's switch it to 45. That one. Can't wait to see the playback on this one to see if it comes out. But yeah, that's cool. Speed calibration disc. Made in China crap, but it works. Okay, so next things to do are for me to adjust the tracking weight. I've got a little scale that should help me do that. So I read that this stylus wants 2 grams, so we'll adjust it to somewhere around 2 grams. I'll have to rummage around for my scale for that, and then we've got to clean this thing up as best we can, which I'll probably do on some sort of time-lapse, fast-forwardy thing. So, yeah, I'll try and find my little scale. Okay, so off-camera, I just gave these a proper squeeze from them. So got on there and gave them a good old squish. And now they're really tight and resist making terrible noises even if you wiggle them around. So yeah, just thought I'd show you that. bit of overkill on the implement selected, but yeah, did your job. Okay, so anyway, what I did is I put the little guard down over the stylus. Turn our crappy little scales on. Okay, so I don't know if you can see that, we're getting 2.41, so that's okay. I adjusted the weights, so that's like coarse adjustment and this one's fine adjustment, so I'll show you on this one. I'll just slide that one back and forth a bit. So I slide it backwards and we get lighter. So that's a fine adjustment. We've done it. Okay, and that one, again, same principle, slide it back and forth, counterbalance, is coarse adjustment. And we've also got this, which I think is an anti-skating sort of a system. Yeah, it doesn't have much impact on a tracking force. So I think this is to draw the arm, give it a bit of a bias towards the inside. Okay, so let's just have another little play of a record now that we've finished all our adjustments. Ooh, look at that. Not like that, does it? Ah! Left the needle guard down. What a goon. Anyway. Getting too into that. So yeah, that seems to be working a treat. So yeah, I'll get to cleaning it up. Okay, so getting to cleaning it up. We have our first disaster, 205,000 year old glue has failed. And knob and cap have come apart on that corner. Why am I doing this while I've still got a record on it? Celebrity playout. There you go. It works. It looks damn cool. Thank you for watching.